Rise, Meg.
The Force will be with you.
So I want to share with you a theory that I thought of the other day that shed some light on the confusing and contradictory backstory of the sequel trilogy's most infamous villain, Supreme Leader Snoke. The theory entails the notion that Snoke is not the specimen we saw in the cloning facility in The Mandalorian Chapter 12, but rather the person responsible for it. I know that not everyone is keen on the sequels, and you've probably already started typing how the sequels aren't canon and something about Kathleen Kennedy, but please bear with me and give this theory a chance. The premise for our theory is something Snoke said with confidence, that he had witnessed the rise and fall of the Galactic Empire. With the Rise of Skywalker later suggesting that Snoke was just a Strandcast clone, this confused us because how could he have seen the Empire rise if he was created after Return of the Jedi? Well, what if he wasn't, and did actually witness the Empire's rise? What if the clones we saw in Episode 9 were clones of Snoke, rather than Snoke clones? Let me explain. In Revenge of the Sith, Palpatine knew that Anakin, or rather, newly anointed Darth Vader, would face off against Obi-Wan. He knew that there was a chance that Vader would lose, and therefore, he needed a backup plan. What if he had created Snoke a few years prior, and had him on standby throughout the prequel trilogy? There is, after all, evidence to back this up. Palpatine was obsessed with overcoming death, as we learned in Revenge of the Sith, but his fascination for control of midichlorians and death goes way back. If you read James Luceno's phenomenal novel, Darth Plagueis, you'll know that Palpatine had been picking at his ex-master's brain for years, and began learning these powers and Sith secrets right after killing him during the events of The Phantom Menace. What if Palpatine had been experimenting with cloning throughout the prequel trilogy, and had created Snoke as a prototype for a future apprentice? This would be in line with what Palpatine said in Episode 9 to Kylo Ren, that he made Snoke, and it would also help make sense of Snoke claiming to have seen the rise and fall of the Empire. In essence, Snoke has been around since the prequel trilogy, and Palpatine was likely training him in the shadows. So how does this play into The Mandalorian? Simply put, Palpatine was arrogant, but smart. He didn't think he was going to die at the hands of Vader in Episode 6, but he did. He had probably put in place a plan of action years before in the instance of his death. Part of this plan was the reliance on Snoke, since he was creating using Palpatine's blood and essence. Another theory is that Palpatine had saved blood samples prior to his death wherever his cloning facility was. As we learned in The Mandalorian, another vital ingredient was Grogu's blood, but it took searching the galaxy for the Imperial Remnant to discover a Force sensitive as powerful as the child is. So my main point is this, since we know the First Order has already begun sowing its seed with the aim of restoring order to the galaxy in the form of the Emperor, what if Snoke is the real big bad behind the Imperial Remnant and all of Moff Gideon's experiments? With Gideon now arrested and in the custody of the New Republic, could Snoke make himself known in Season 3? And another question is, what will the cloning project lead to before Palpatine returns many years later in The Rise of Skywalker? Since we saw so many clones being created in Chapter 12, could Snoke and Gideon be trying to clone an entire Force-sensitive army at the same time as working on bringing Palpatine back? I think we'll get a lot more answers in The Mandalorian Season 3, but I wanted to share this theory with you guys today. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and I'll see you in the next one. I'm Star Wars Meg, wishing you a phenomenal rest of the day, no matter where you dwell in the galaxy. Have a good one.